Rahman Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most kind. Put some gratitude into your attitude. There is always something to be thankful for. Gratitude is a description of a successful mode of living. The thankful heart opens our eyes to a multitude of blessings that continually surround us. So Allah also says in the Holy Quran, if you thank me, I will give you more. So be thankful to every little blessing you have. Today we will discuss light microscopic morphological changes in renal glomeruli. First of all, there is some terms we should know. Diffuse means all the glomeruli in the kidney are involved. And focal means a fraction of glomeruli in the kidneys are involved. So if all glomeruli involved, the term is diffuse, and if few, some, then focal. Now if pertaining to the single glomerulus, if whole glomerulus is involved, it is global. If portion of the glomerulus is involved, it is called segmental. So we have learned diffuse and focal, segmental and global. Now this is the normal glomerulus. You can appreciate a glomerulus has fine capillary loops. There is mesangium and there is Bowman's space. If you divide the glomerulus into four halves, there is no difference between the four halves. This is the diagrammatic presentation of glomerulus under electron microscopy. There is basement membrane. One side of the basement membrane are endothelial cells, on the other side are epithelial cells, and there is mesangial matrix. Now this glomeruli may have hypercellularity. You can appreciate neutrophils, multilobe nuclei of the neutrophils. There are numerous nuclei in the glomerulus. There is also mesangial cell proliferation. Mesangial cells are actually macrophages, and there is also proliferation of the endothelial cells. So hypercellularity can be due to leukocyte infiltrate, epithelial cell proliferation, endothelial cell or mesangial cell proliferation. You can compare the normal glomerulus with the hypercellular glomerulus. Now in this photomicrograph, you can appreciate a crescent. This is due to the proliferation of parietal epithelial cells. Because crescent, this is the half moon shape. So this results from proliferation of parietal epithelial cells. This is also is a hypercellular glomerulus. You can compare in this slide with the normal glomerulus. Now in this photomicrograph, you can see thickening of capillary walls. Capillary walls are thickened, but there is no increase in the cellularity. You can compare the both photomicrographs. Left side is normal glomerulus and thickened capillary walls. Now there is another term, hyalinosis, which means there is deposition of acellular pink material on light microscopy. So here are these may be due to proteinaceous material. And then there is another term, sclerosis. Glomerular sclerosis occur due to the collagen deposition. So there is almost no capillary tufts remained in the center of the glomerulus. This is called sclerosed glomerulus. So I think you can now better understand the different morphological features of glomerulus on light microscopy. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel, like and share video.